Research on type 2 diabetes is extremely critical today because so many people are suffering from it worldwide. Here in the United States, 9% of the population already lives with this disease. A hallmark of diabetes is higher than normal glucose levels in the bloodstream. So as glucose is the main source of energy for our cells, the glucose from the food we eat gets delivered into our bloodstream for all organs to use it as a source of energy. This range of glucose in the bloodstream is, however, kept at a very narrow range in a healthy individual. And what goes wrong in diabetes, and one of the first things that actually signals the progression to the disease, is the so-called insulin resistance. Insulin resistance means that the insulin signaling is disrupted and our bodies can no longer either synthesize enough or use insulin properly. And despite enormous progress that has been made in the research on diabetes and in understanding of both insulin resistance and diabetes, we still need to do more work because we still lack precise knowledge about primary factors that trigger these disorders at the cellular level. The Montminy Lab has a long-standing expertise in the fields of both glucose and fat metabolisms. And the lab has focused its research on metabolic switches, which are proteins that mediate gene expression following a nutritional or hormonal cues. A new project that we will be working on involves the communication between the nucleus where gene expression occurs and another organelle from the cell, which is called the mitochondrion. We will study this communication between mitochondria and the nucleus. We will also investigate whether this communication can be disrupted early in the onset of disorders such as insulin resistance and diabetes. Studying the energy metabolism and signaling will help us complete the picture about how all these metabolic pathways are interlaced and how they work together. And more we know about it, more we will be able to think about useful strategies in designing drugs and preventing and curing metabolic disorders such as insulin resistance and diabetes. I'd like to thank the Salk Accelerators for their generous support of the Institute, and I'm very honored to be this year's recipient of the Salk Accelerator Fellowship. Thank you again for supporting the science at Salk.